गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम चिन्मय हेगड़े। दिस इज ऑनलाइन इकोनॉमिक्स क्लास, द सब्जेक्ट कर्नाटका इकोनॉमी। वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट वेरियस टॉपिक्स अबाउट द कर्नाटका इकोनॉमी एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट इन कर्नाटका। इन इकोनॉमिक्स और इन इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट, human resource or human development is very important or very essential for using other physical resources. So totally physical resources are best or optimum utilized with best or superior human resources or well qualified human resources. So therefore human development or human capital formation is very important for economic development. Human development in Karnataka, it can be studied with the demographic characteristics, the composition of our population and other some indicators of demography. First one is the introduction about human development. The Karnataka has been fast growing economy due to the large knowledge base of the society, which can certainly be attributed to significant reforms in human development and education sector. Here, human development refers to the physical, cognitive and psychosocial development of humans throughout the lifespan. And normally human development, which indicates that improving the quality of human resources. Here human resources, it indicates that people in the economy who have knowledge, skill, training and experience that individuals need to produce goods and services. An investment in human resources is an investment in economic development, and this human resources can be developed through the investment in education and healthcare sector. Here investment in human resources, it indicates that there is some sources of human capital formation, and those sources are, first of all, very important sources are expenditure on education sector and expenditure on healthcare sector. And some other sources are expenditure on training, expenditure on migration, or expenditure on maybe sanitation and some other things. If we invest in these sectors, in these aspects of the economy which influence human capital or human resources in positive manner, which makes human capital formation. And in the human development aspect, we can analyze these human development with some demographic indicators. Some important demographic indicators are, as per our 2011 census, the total number of population in Karnataka is 6.1 crores, almost 6.2 crores, which is 121 crore in India. In our country, it is 121 crore. In our state, it is 6 crore population. And it composed with male and female population, which is 3 crores of male population and 3 crores of female population. And in case of our country, it has 62 crores male and 58 crores of female population. In our state, male and female composition of population is almost 51% male population and 49% is female population. And in case of rural-urban composition, rural urban composition with our population as 61.3% rural population and 38.7% urban population in Karnataka. It is in our state total population composed as 61% rural and 38% urban population. And in case of our country, it is 68% and 31% rural and urban population respectively. And then the decadal growth rate of population, which indicates that total 10 years population from one census to next census. It is 2001 to 2011 census, the 10 years population growth rate was 15.6% in Karnataka and 17.7% in India. It is national level measurement, 17.7% decadal growth rate of population, 15.6% state level decadal growth rate of population. And literacy rate, it is very important indicator in terms of human development. The literacy rate is far better compared to Indian context. In our state, 75.36% literacy rate in Karnataka. That means 75% population are literate persons. They are educated, they are able to read and write. And in case of our country, 73% population are the literate population. And some other demographic indicators are the density of population. Density of population is measured as the total number of people live in per square kilometer land area, and that is 319 people in our state, and it is 382 people in India. The density of population is more in our country and it is some extent less in our state. 319 people in Karnataka, 382 people in per square kilometers land area in it is in India. And then the next one indicator is sex ratio, or it may be called as gender composition. Gender composition is measured as the total number of females per 1,000 males, and it is 973 females per 1,000 males in Karnataka in our state, and 940 females per 1,000 males in India. And in case of the change in number of population, that is defined with birth rate and death rate. And as per the birth rate, 17.6 per 1,000 people, the total number of live birth per 1,000 population. It is measured as total number of live birth per 1,000 population. It is measured, and this data is measured with percentage. And also death rate, 6.7 per 1,000 people. And the next one indicator is infant mortality rate. It is 24 infant mortality per 1,000 live birth. 24 infant mortality. Infant mortality, it indicates that the mortality at the stage, at the infant stage, below 1 year baby mortality. And that is 24 per 1,000 live birth. And another one very important indicator of human development, it is one systematic indicator, that is HDI, Human Development Index. Human Development Index, that is prepared by UNDP, United Nations Organization, and that indicator defined with or measured with values, and that gives some ranks to every one country, and also we measure in our state. And that rank for Karnataka is, we have 8th rank with value 0.611. And in India, HDI value is 0.554. And as per this HDI value, our state is in better position as compared to national level. Our country has, it's more than 100th rank in all over the world. Total worldwide countries measurement, our country has almost 129th rank. And in our country, our state has 8th rank. In HDI ranks in our country, Kerala state has 1st rank. So because this HDI measures with different other parameters, such as can explain as HDI measures with different major indicators like long and healthy life. A long and healthy life measured as life expectancy at birth. It's a longevity of persons. And second one is knowledge of human resource. That knowledge is measured as some schooling, mean year of schooling, enrollment of schooling. It explains that the enrollment of education, enrollment to education, educational sector. And another one parameter is standard of living. Your standard of living is normally measured with our national income, GDP. If increase in GDP, it indicates that in some extent, which indicates that increase in standard of living. And the composite, all these measurements or indicators that measures the human development index, human development in that particular area. So it is very important index for human development measurement. And also we have some other indexes, gender equity index, some other types of index, physical quality life index, various indexes there. But very important is human development index. Okay, in the human resource and human development in Karnataka, our state government stressed more on education and healthcare sectors, and also it has various policies and programs for improving these two services, educational service and healthcare service. Also various departments for their improvement measures. So, okay, in our next class, we discuss about some other topics about the Karnataka economy. Okay, thank you.